Welcome back to the Sketch and Guess video tutorial. This is part 3, where we will be completing the CloudDB functionality and making sure that the guesser can try and guess from an set of options and the sketcher is told what drawing to make. Let's get started. These blocks should have been part of your template that you downloaded. I hid them away previously, but now let me address them. This is a list of the drawing options that the sketcher has. We'll be picking one randomly and having the sketcher draw it. The current drawing is what the sketcher is drawing at this time, and currently it's set to nothing, but as soon as we choose a drawing option, it'll be set to that value. All of this happens when the sketcher presses the start button. So let's go to start button and do whenStartButton.click. So when the start button is clicked, we're going to be picking a random element from the drawing options. The way to do that is we're going to be setting the current drawing, which is our variable, to pick a random item from the list. So you can go to list, pick a random item, and the list we want to pick from is drawing options. Okay, this will set the current drawing to be a random element from drawing options. And then we'll want it to show up on the actual screen in the drawing label. So we'll set the drawing label text field to say draw whatever is our current drawing. To do this, we're going to join two words together. Draw A, and the second part is going to be our variable current drawing. That way the label will say draw A, whatever this is, sun, moon, party, whatever it could be. Okay, and since we're starting a new drawing, we'll also call canvas.clear for convenience. Great. So now we need to send this information out through CloudDB. Of course, the way that we do that is through store value. This will be a new tag. Let's call this tag current drawing. And the value that we're storing is the variable current drawing. So get current drawing. There we go. That will actually store the value. Now we'll be going on to the guesser screen and getting that value. You can see that there is the drawing options list set up for you already. And let's set up the answer spinner first. So remember, the answer spinner is basically a set of multiple choice options, and we want the options to be the contents of drawing options. That way the guesser can try and guess which of these images is being drawn. So let's go to guesser screen and do whenGuesserScreen.initialize. So this is the first time the guesser screen is opened. We're going to set up the spinner. So to do the spinner, we go to answer spinner and set its elements. So these are the options that it has. And what we want is to be the contents of the list drawing options. So we can just go into variables and do get drawing options. Okay, so now let's do the CloudDB component. Let's take a look again at what we've done so far. Here, this is when the data changed, and we've checked if it's drawing data, but now we need to check the current image that's being drawn. So let's check for that tag. Pull out another if statement, right? And let's put it below this first if statement, right at the very bottom. So instead of checking if the tag is equal to drawing data, we're going to check if the tag is equal to current drawing. So here's the equal sign in logic. the tag is going to be available in here. Get tag. And the variable that we're looking for is, of course, going to be current drawing. So we can write that out. Text current drawing. Okay, so if the tag is current drawing, then we know what the current drawing is. So we can set the variable set current drawing to be the value that we've gotten from CloudDB. Okay, so now we have the current drawing stored with the guesser. So when the guesser makes a guess, they select from the answer spinner. When they do, we're going to check if the guess is correct. So click on answer spinner and do when answer spinner dot after selecting. So this happens as soon as the guesser has selected a possible answer. And the selection here is what has been chosen in the answer spinner. So it's going to be one of the options of the drawing. So we need to check if the selection that's been picked is the correct current drawing. To do this, let's grab an if then else statement. So what we need to check is if the selection is equal to the current drawing variable. So let's go to and get the equal sign. The selection we can just get from here, hover, click, and drag. And the variable can get from the variables drawer, drag that in, and pick current drawing. So if the selection is equal to the current drawing, that means that the guesser got it correctly. So we can use a notifier, which makes a little pop-up appear on screen. Go down to notifier 1 and do call notifier.showAlert. And this will have a little pop-up on screen. And let's have the text of the pop-up, drag in a text box. Let's maybe have it say, that's right. Good job. So this is if the selection is equal, then we show the winning alert. Else means that the selection is not equal and the guesser has given a wrong answer. So we can still show an alert, but it should have a different text. Let's just duplicate this, drag it into the else, and instead of that's right, let's say, oh no, try again. And there we go. That has completed the guesser section of the sketch and guess. Now is the time to test it out. Remember, to test it out with more than one player, go up to build, and you can provide a QR code that the users can then download to their own phones. You can also save it as an APK and send it to your friends via email. Okay, so now the last thing we're going to need to do is notify all players when a correct guess has been made. That way, you can have multiple guessers and they all get the notification that a correct guess has been made. So this happens here if the selection is equal to the current drawing and we need to save that to CloudDB. Go to CloudDB and pull out the store value, call clouddb.storeValue. All right? And the value that we want to store is just the selection here. It's also equal to the current drawing. So it doesn't matter which one you pick, but I'm going to do current drawing. Right, and the tag will be anything descriptive. So I'm going to call it correct guess. There we go. Now it's saved CloudDB. So if a guesser realizes that there's been a correct guess, then of course we need to have that reflect in the CloudDB.dataChanged block. So we need to do if the tag is equal to now correct guess. So I'm actually just going to duplicate this if statement and put it right below. Of course, we're not going to be doing this current drawing. And the tag is going to be correct guess instead. So if the tag is actually equal to correct guess, then we want to have the notifier give an alert. So do notifier.showAlert, and we're going to have it say the drawing of a, whatever the drawing is, has been guessed correctly. So to do this, we're going to need to join three different pieces of text. Go ahead and pull out a join block. And since it's three instead of two, let's add a third one by clicking on the gear and dragging in a third string. That way you can see there's now three different blocks available. For the first one, let's put in some text and do the drawing of a, and then the object that's actually been drawn, of course, is the value that's been stored to CloudDB. So let's grab the value from up here. And then the last one is some more text, which is has been guessed correctly. Okay, and that's all we need for the guesser notification. For the sketcher notification, we want this same big if block of if the tag is equal to the correct guess, give an alert. And a very handy way to copy code between screens is to use the backpack. This is the backpack right here, and it can store snippets of code between screens or even projects. To do this, drag your if block to the backpack, and when it opens, release it. You can see that now the backpack is full of blocks. Put this back in. And now let's go to the Sketcher screen. For the Sketcher screen, it doesn't have a data changed block yet. So let's go ahead and do when CloudDB.data changed. And then all we want is the if statement that we just saved in our backpack. So let's click on the backpack and do and drag it out. And there we go. Now we've completed the communication between the guesser and the sketcher and set the when state. If you've gotten this far, then congratulations. You've completed the Sketch and Guess tutorial. Remember, go ahead and check it by scrolling up and going to Build and setting the QR code. Now, I'll go ahead and set up a quick test and give you a demo of the completed app.
Okay, so now you should have been able to complete all of the features of the Sketch and Guess app. There can be live changes to the screens. The clear button works across CloudDB. You can press for a new picture to get an instruction. And if you guess correctly, then you get the notification and it also will show up on the other screen. Of course, if you were to guess incorrectly, see this says draw a horse, and if you were to guess a video game, it says, oh no, try again. This is the added functionality of the notifier that we just did. Now, if you've gotten this far and can navigate between screens, then congratulations, you have completed the Sketch and Guess app. There's tons of different options for you to continue. Feel free to add more optionalities. So remember, you don't have to just have these. You can have any topics you like. So you can make a themed Sketch and Guess for maybe plants or animals or whatever your party demands. Or you could change the function of the game to have it have multiple sketchers. Right now, there's the option for multiple guessers. But to have multiple sketchers, you'd have to add some extra parameters to the CloudDB.dataChanged of the sketcher. I'll leave that up to you and anything else that you can happen to think of. Good luck and congratulations once again.